China has vented its fury at Australia's nuclear submarine deal with the UK and US, accusing it of accelerating an arms race. Their state media is warning us to brace for the worst as our government looks at bringing more US bombers and surveillance planes down under.
Expect to see more of this. American forces and military aircraft training on Australian shores. The result of high-level talks in Washington.
The unbreakable alliance.
Breaking new ground with a trilateral deal with the UK to build nuclear-powered submarines here as the region becomes more dangerous.
We're just doing what we need to do to keep Australians safe and protect our national interests.
The historic AUKUS pact attracting condemnation from Beijing, which has its own fleet of nuclear-powered submarines.
US, UK and Australia are engaging in cooperation in nuclear-powered submarines that gravely undermines regional peace and stability, aggravates arms race.
The state-run Global Times claiming since Australia has become an anti-China spearhead, the country should prepare for the worst. Australian troops are also most likely to be the first batch of Western soldiers to waste their lives in the South China Sea.
I think their comments are counterproductive and immature.
We will remain clear-eyed in our view of Beijing's efforts to undermine the established international order.
Using alliances to chart a peaceful path ahead for the troubled Indo-Pacific.
The United States will not leave Australia alone on the field.
While China's angry over the security deal, close neighbour Indonesia says it's watching with caution, very concerned about the continued arms race. And France says it's upset Australia sunk its $90 billion submarine deal in favour of the AUKUS arrangement.
We were not informed.
There had been an ongoing process for some months, and that began with the dinner I had with President Macron back in late June.
While it's thought there won't be long-term damage in the relationship with France, the relationship with China and a more assertive Beijing is another story.
Currently, the difficulties in China-Australia relations is caused single-handedly by the Australian side.
Australia says the door remains open for talks.
It seems to me that mature actors would consider that in a constructive way.
Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.